Hey guys, Shock here bringing you Wi-Fi battle number 49. This is round one of the Killer Nacho's Monocolor tournament. Monocolor white versus Monocolor yellow. Can I pull off the upset? Songs Astronomy by Blue Oyster Cult. He leads with boots. I lead with my protector, my Gardevoir. And he uses bite, and he's going to get the flinch hex, which mattered. So, there goes my Gardevoir. I'm now going to go into Abominus now. And I'm going to use Ice Shard as a priority move. Plus, I forget what I got on this. Choice Band is going, his U-turn is going to do 144 damage. So, that'd be a 3-hit KO with U-turn. He goes into his Jirachi, his clown. And I'm going to switch here into my Galad, which he's going to trick me a Choice Scarf. So I'm like, this sucks. I'm going to go with the EQ, because I've got max attack on this thing, 383, which is pretty good. I think it is the max attack. That's going to nearly one-hit KO him. If I still had the expert belt, that would have KO'd him. And he T-Ways. And that paralysis on that Galad's going to matter. So, I go back into Abominus now, which he's going to U-turn. And that's going to nearly kill Abominus now, but I live. So he goes back into boots, which I'm hoping the Ice Shard that I show off next will kill him. But he's got Fake Out, which is a higher priority move. So there goes my Abominus now. So I go into my low salve, my Absol, and this Choice Scarfed actually. So Sucker Punch, because he's got 394 max attack. So Choice Scarf was like the only option for a Absol to live and kill things. So go low salve. So he goes into Clown, and he's gonna T-Wave my Absol, and I'm just like, okay. So we both get buffeted by the hail. Sucker Punch kills off at Jirachi. And honestly, he had the team I thought he would. Just certain things cause different things to happen in the battle. So he goes into Squatch. And I'm going to Sucker Punch, hoping I can do significant damage. Maybe get a crit. And nope, he gets Cross Chop, doesn't miss. And there goes my low sap. So I go into back into my PK Sparks, and he's gonna switch into Moon Knight. Now this is where I get a nice pre-deck. Moon Knight. I think that's how you pronounce it. Doesn't do too much. I'm like, oh my god. You gotta be kidding me. And he's a screener. And I'm like, crap. So Night Slash is gonna do like next to nothing. But I'm stuck into it because of the Choice Scarf I got tricked to earlier. So he's gonna use Moonlight. But thanks to Hail, he's not gonna get back that full HP, so yay. Sorry. So he goes into his Broster, and I'm like, ack. Switching into my Zachary. My Zangoose. And Curse Claw hits, but doesn't do too much. And I get the defense drop, but it really doesn't matter because now he agilities. And I'm like, that's different. I haven't seen an agiliting Moltres in any Wi-Fi battle video I've watched or any Wi-Fi battle I've ever done. Excuse me there. And he's going to Fire Blast, and that's obviously going to one-hit KO the Zangoose, because Zangoose has, like, paper-thin defense and special defense. So I go into my Infidel, which Fire Blast is going to bring this thing into killing range. Like, he's going to put me in the red zone. I'm going to kill his Roastry. So he sends into his Squatch. Got my dog in my arms. So, and then he's going to T-Punch, which is always going to kill off my Infidel. So all I got left is my paralyzed Gallade named PK Sparks. So he's going to Fire Punch, and I think that one-hit KOs my PK Sparks. No, I live, but Night Slash doesn't KO him because of... No, it does KO. Alright. So I'm like, alright, what's his last one? I bet it's a Jolteon. I so bet it's a Jolteon. That's Career of Evil by the Blue Oyster Cult. And, oh, I am so right. It was a Jolteon. So, good game, Phallics. I hope you continue to advance in the TheKillerNacho's tournament. Best of luck to you. Rate, comment, subscribe. Link to his YouTube channel in the descript. Link to pokeladder in the descript. All that good stuff. See you guys later. Peace.